Let us do a practice problem on liquidity position of the business, the short-term financial position of the business. On the screen, I have a list of account balances. These are picked from, say, the financial statements of the company. And what we have to do is to comment on the liquidity position of this company. In order to comment on liquidity position of the company, there are three indicators that we use. Number one, there is current ratio, there is liquid ratio, and there is absolute liquid ratio. Three numbers. Let's look at the contents of these. In the current ratio, we take current assets, divide them by current liabilities. In the liquid ratio, we take only the liquid assets, which is equal to current asset minus stock and prepaid expenses, divide them by current liabilities. In absolute liquid ratio, we take absolute liquid assets, which are cash and cash equivalents, and divide them by current liabilities. What we're trying to do is to comment on the position of the business, the ability of the business to pay off its current liabilities using its current assets, its liquid assets, and its absolute liquid assets. Let's look at these terms and see if there is something which we do not know. Cash in hand is a current asset, we know very well. Cash at bank is also a current asset. Sundry basically means, you know, large number of small customers clubbed together. So debtors, money to be recovered, current assets. The stock is also a current asset. Bills payable is a current liability. Bills receivables are current assets. Sundry creditors, again, sundry means the same. Various small vendors to whom you have to pay, current liability. Outstanding expenses are also current liability. Prepaid expenses are expenses paid in advance, so current assets. Dividend payable are current liability. Now, this is something that we've not discussed before. Dividend payable refers to the equity dividend, which the company has declared, but the shareholder has not claimed yet. So there is a process through which the dividend is finally paid to the shareholders. And the company, after deciding that this much amount is to be paid, they keep that amount in a separate bank account separately so that it's not used for other purposes. This amount has to be claimed by the shareholders. Shareholders have to provide some information to receive this amount. And until that time, until the time that this money of dividend is distributed, this amount is treated as a liability on the company, because the company does not have a claim on this dividend. The shareholders have. And shareholders are a separate legal entity of the business. So when it says payable, we treat it as a current liability, and you expect to pay it off, you know, as soon as possible within next 1 year. Land and building is not a current asset, not a current liability. So we're not going to consider this here. And you have goodwill. Goodwill again is a long-term asset, and we're not going to consider it in the current assets. However, we need to discuss what goodwill is. Goodwill is, you know, when business A purchases business B. So business A has purchased business B. Business B's value was 100, but business A agreed to pay 120 for it because, you know, the negotiation happened and, you know, B convinced A to pay this much, or A, you know, saw the benefit in paying more and closing the deal. Otherwise, you know, another company, C, would have bought B. So by buying B, A hopes to, you know, make more money in the future, benefit from the existing business of B, and, you know, make more, have more sales. So this additional 20 which has been paid, why has this been paid? This has been paid because B had some goodwill in the market. B had a reputation in the market. B had a customer base in the market. So this additional 20 is regarded as purchase of reputation. This is something which is going to benefit company A in the long run. It will help it in the generation of revenue in the long run. Therefore, goodwill is treated as a non-current asset. and also it is an intangible asset. You can't see it. So for example, Facebook purchased WhatsApp. So it was, but I think the transaction happened at about $19 billion. And the actual value of WhatsApp must have been much low. But what Facebook saw was a benefit in the user base that WhatsApp had. And after the purchase, if you've noticed, you know, if you have somebody on your WhatsApp list, then you see a friend suggestion of that person by the Facebook. Facebook gives you a friend suggestion of that person on the Facebook as well. So, you know, they're utilizing the user base of WhatsApp to increase their network, the subscribers on the Facebook platform. So that's what, you know, in short, goodwill is. Anyways, the goodwill is not being used in this question at all. So this is the current asset and current liabilities. We also need to figure out if some of these items are going to fall under, you know, liquid assets and absolute liquid assets or not. So cash in hand certainly falls under the current asset category. Cash in hand is also going to be treated as a liquid asset and absolute liquid asset. Bank balance, same. Debtors are going to be treated here, but not here. Stock is not going to be included here, neither here. Bills payable are current liabilities. So maybe I'll have a column for current liabilities. So I'll check here. Bills receivable are liquid assets. Yes, not absolute liquid asset. Creditors are current liabilities. Outstanding expenses are current liabilities. Prepaid expenses are not included in the liquid assets nor in the absolute liquid assets. Dividend payable are current liabilities. So there you go. Current liabilities have 1, 2, 3 and 4 items, and absolute liquid assets have 2 items. Liquid assets have 3 and 4 items, and current assets have actually more than all of these. So 5, 6, 7 items in total. So all we have to do is sum these up and calculate the numbers. So the total of the current asset is going to be 25, this is 1,60,000, 1,90,000, and then you have 2 lakhs. So the current assets are 2 lakhs, divide them by current liabilities. Current liabilities are equal to 25,000 plus these two, so this is 60,85,000 and this 1 lakh. So 1 lakh is current liability total. There you go. The current ratio comes out to be 2:1, which means the current assets are twice the size of current liabilities, which means you can afford to lose half of your current assets and still be able to pay your current liabilities. It's a good situation to be in. Again, we do not have the industry standard here, but you know, it's double the current liabilities. The current assets have enough cushion to pay off the current liabilities. Done. Let's go to liquid ratio. In liquid ratio, stock and prepaid expenses are going to be excluded. So only liquid assets are going to be used. So 1 and 2, these two terms go out, so 10,000 and 60,000. So 70,000 should be reduced, which means 130,000 should be the total for liquid assets. Divide this by current liabilities, which is 100,000, 1 lakh, and you have 1:3:1 as the liquid ratio. This means if the stock and prepaid expenses are ruled out because they do not give you cash, still you will have current liquid assets, which will be 1.3 times the current liabilities, meaning you can afford to lose 30% of your liquid assets and still be able to pay off your current liabilities. Great, good position to be in. Let's look at the third ratio, which is absolute liquid assets. It is going to include only these two. This is 25,000. So 25,000 divided by 100,000, 1 lakh. This gives us a ratio of 0.25:1, which means if you were supposed to pay your current liabilities right away within a couple of days using the cash and bank balance and the marketable securities that you had, you will not be able to meet them. You only have 1/4 of the current liabilities. You will not be pay off 75% of the current liabilities. So that's the short-term position of the business. So what? How would you come to a conclusion if you have to comment? In terms of satisfactory or unsatisfactory, would you click on satisfactory or unsatisfactory? Well, in order to do that, you need a benchmark. You need to say, what am I comparing against? So current ratio, then you have liquid ratio and absolute liquid ratio. So the benchmark, let's say the top five competitors have an average current ratio of 2.5:1. The liquid ratio, on the other hand, is 1.5:1, and absolute liquid ratio is 1:1. If these were the numbers, then you would say no, unsatisfactory. The short-term financial position is unsatisfactory compared to the industry, compared to our top five competitors. So there you go. That's how you comment on short-term financial position of a company. I'll see you in the next video.